So make that choice. Make it a good one.
Loving South Yorkshire and North Derbyshire. Diana Luke, BBC Radio Sheffield.
We got a message in. I got to read this one out. This just makes me laugh. We got a message in from Rob, and he says, "This is something I really must share with you about tomorrow, and this only happened to me today. I've been at work all day today, which is not a normal Saturday for me. So at lunchtime, I decide to do a route planner for the journey, because he's coming to the big meetup tomorrow. All right. And he says, I'm not that familiar with Sheffield. I typed my home postcode in, then BBC Radio Sheffield address, and walked away from my office PC. When I returned to pick up the route, it turns out that if I follow what a certain motoring organization's advice is, I may be just a little late in arriving, as the total journey time from my home in Durham to BBC Sheffield is 29 hours, 17 minutes, covering a journey of 1,787 miles, as we would have to go via the country of Bosnia in order to meet up. I've decided just to use my line manager's sat-nav instead. I do hope you make it on time, Rob. Unbelievable journey that is, but fabulous that you're coming all the way from Durham. That is absolutely wonderful. So just to reiterate for anyone that hasn't got back in touch, and yes, I have got your details there, Maureen and Golkar and other people that have mentioned that they don't want other people to know and all that kind of stuff. Yes, I have got your messages. But please, could you either text me or email me tonight? I can't take it any later than that. If I haven't heard from you, please understand that we have to have security to know who is actually coming to the studio. So you can email me tonight. The cutoff is within the next half hour, okay? And that's diana.luke@bbc.co.uk, or you can text 81333 with my name, Diana, at the beginning. The meet will be at 12:45 outside the gates at BBC Radio Sheffield, 54 Shoreham Street. That's S14RS. Now, there is free parking for 2 hours at St. Mary's Gate. It's a little shopping centre with a big furniture shop there and so forth. It's about 3 minutes walk away, so you can park your car there because you're only going to be here for an hour, aren't you? So that just saves you a little bit of money. Just walk over to the station. So make sure you're here for 12:45, and then we'll all come into the studio and you can see where we make the shows happen on both Saturday and Sunday night, and you can meet up with each other. We might even do a little cryptic clue or a little beat the intro in the studio just for a bit of fun. Do you remember to bring your camera so you can get a picture of yourself sitting in the hot seat with the headphones on and the microphone in front of you and all that kind of stuff. And Tim's going to be filming you as well, so it's all happening tomorrow from 12:45. You must let me know tonight if you haven't already, okay?
We're going to put little labels on everyone's
name. Oh, right. Okay, good to see you.
Now, who do we start with? Let's have a name here. What's your name? Peter. Do you come in?
My local station, so quite an easy journey.
Oh, really. Fantastic. I'm so glad you made it.
I know, if I
can. Everybody's here. You can tell me that you're coming again to the second one, but that's fine. We're here.
Thanks for having a chance.
Who else we got? They got there.
Hi.
Around there.
Oh, it's perfect.
Is it?
Oh, yes.
Lots of nice places to walk.
Straight out to your front door and you're on the wall.
And the way you took my voice off was hilarious. We're going to have to do it. Here it is. Remember where everyone is. So lovely to see you again. That's not the same without Julie, is it?
No.
Bless her. She was so lovely.
Julie wanted to talk
about her. The nose was absolutely pushed down.
Wow. Well.
Yeah, we left one of them. Can we?
Yes.
We left about 4:45.
I want to know if I could work with her.
Oh, right. Yeah, okay.
They got nowhere near, so that's sort of a... Anyway, yeah, so I also look after the boys as well.
And all the rest of it. And I think that keeps us young, because you can get up and dance through it as well, which is, I think, one of the most important things. Okay, and Sid. Now, Sid, we have to... Yes. Why are we clapping? Because Sid always wins. Sometimes you spell it so quickly, it's hard for me to decipher.
Yeah, you want me to change that?
No, you'd lose seconds. You definitely lose seconds.
It can be split seconds, literally.
You have, yes, yeah. You are very fast.
And stumbled across the 60's programme whilst out in the caravan, I think, many years ago, and thought, she's playing some darn good music. Did a competition, I didn't remember that, and I thought, nobody's getting the answer. So I texted in and got the right answer. And then I was hooked, simple as that. Saturday nights, as it was then, 9 o'clock, now 10 o'clock, 60's music, can't beat it.
The music is reminiscent of our youth when we got together, when we met, and it just brings back so many happy times.
Yeah, because we met in 66, so we've been married 43 years now, so it does hold a lot of nice memories for us.
One of the reasons I really enjoy Diana's show, well, both of them actually, but the 60's one, I was brought up in the 70s, but my mum always had music from the 60s playing while I was growing up in the kitchen, in the car, everywhere. And I've known lots and lots of the songs, but I've never been able to put an artist towards the two of them. I find the show is I'm able to marry the two together.
I like the show because it's got 60s music.
We listen to Diana every Saturday evening. We just love the 60s. Music.
Yes, indeed.
And I love to hear Diana's voice. I think she's a wonderful voice.
Because I followed her from real radio and she is just, it's just her Canadian voice.
I listen mainly on a Saturday evening and, she's just so relaxed and, you know, I just like to hear her voice and what the music she plays.
Basically, I just wanted to see who owned that fantastic voice. She comes across as such a caring person and I think she makes everybody feel individual. And I like the music and it's just followed on from there. I've been maybe about 2 years I've listened to it and I really enjoy it. I look forward to it actually.
I started listening to Diana about 25 years ago.
I've listened to Diana for quite a long time.
And it's just a very special community that you establish with each of the shows, and thank you.
But yeah, it's amazing. I think she's an amazing person. Really like her, I think she's fab.
I really enjoy listening to Diana. She has a very personable attitude. She's knowledgeable of music. She plays something that's out of the ordinary. A lot of these oldie stations, you know what's coming on, but with her she throws a good rock record, psychedelia, or the blues, which especially I like. And she remembers everyone that phones in, nice peculiarities about them, and it's as though she's in the same room with you. So every Saturday I'll just be there listening.
I listen to the show every Saturday night. In fact, it is my Saturday night. Everything I do on a Saturday revolves around the show. I don't go out now on a Saturday night. I just love the music. I love the company that we all keep. And basically everything about the show is just brilliant, really, really do. We now wouldn't miss the show for anything at all. The only one I miss is when I'm on holiday, and then I catch it up when I play.
And I do love to listen to Diana and her accent, because it's so smooth and attractive, this Canadian accent. So it really attracts me, I think. And I like the music she plays, obviously, because I like all music, really.
Diana fits in with the 60s perfectly for me. Plays a lot of the music I like to hear, and throws one or two little competitions in that keeps you focused.
And I've listened to Diana Luke for the past 5 or 6 years, but I used to listen to her on Great Yorkshire Gold. I've got a lot of admiration for Diana for what she's done for me in the past, in 1986, and I'll never forget her for it. I'll never really be able to thank her enough, and I think she's an absolutely terrific person, and I listen to her any time she's on the radio.
We've been listening for quite a while. We originally got into the show because we used to go out on a Saturday night, and coming home we'd listen to the radio and pick Diana up on the radio. And then when we stopped going out so much, we then sort of listened more and more on the radio. And now it's virtually compulsory. In fact, Marilyn calls Diana the other woman in our lives.
Yeah. In a nice way.
Came across Diana's show and very much welcomed the fact that she was playing something rather different from all the party music that all the other stations seemed to play. So I made a point then when I was at home, I felt like listening a bit more often then. Even now, the variety is really good because the music's eclectic. There's so much sort of rock and soul and jazz and psychedelia, for example. And even with Diana herself, when she invites us to partake in these quizzes, she seems to acknowledge every listener as being meaningful in their own right. And she does read out most messages. So it feels in a way like it's a party with all of us together listening to 60s music. And I like the atmosphere as well as obviously the music itself.
Yes, and I started listening to Diana years ago. And I sort of hooked on a Saturday night, because I didn't have to work on a Saturday night. So first thing I'd do is turn on the radio, and then you'd come in from work and you got hooked. Yeah. She sort of draws you in. She's got a lovely, friendly voice. And people on Facebook are so lovely. You know, it's really a great show. In fact, I turn TV off on a Saturday night, full stop, you know, and listen to the radio.
And then Sunday night, obviously, the local of different mix of people, different mix of music, but nevertheless, it's still excellent music, presented superbly by Diana.
Yeah.
And it's because of that, it's the friendly, sort of engaging manner in which she presents it that really holds us in there.
And I started listening to Diana way back in, I think it must have been 80s. She used to do a late programme, I believe, where people used to phone in with problems and so on. And I used to be running a couple of my girls who used to work for me at home. And I'd have the radio on, and she used to be on there at the time.
Oh, your dark horse. Yeah. I didn't know about that. Yeah. Well, I didn't know about her in those days.
Well, you always knew Diana by her distinctive voice, obviously.
Yes, yes.
Which was more distinctive, I would say, in the 80s than it probably is today.
Yes.
She's sort of mellowed.
Mm. Mm. Yeah. And thank you, Diana, for having us all. And you, Tim.
Thank you.
Like Diana, she's helpful, friendly, caring, very, you know, nice to speak to, and it keeps everybody's attention when they're listening to her.
And just thank you so much for all the requests, because she's spot on. She sends it straight away. It means a lot to us. Any messages she sends. She sent it to my sister in London. And just thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
I think she's brilliant. She's one in a million.
I think she's a wonderful person. She gives some great advice. And she is just one in a million. She's a friend that everybody needs.
Just over 12 hours away from meeting up here at BBC Radio Sheffield. 12:45, lunchtime tomorrow. Get yourself parked up or trained in, however you're going to get here. Get here for 12:45, and we're going to have a lovely meet-up. There are a lot of people coming. Let me just have a look here. We've got John and Maureen and Roy and Karen and Chris and Maxine and Rich and Lisa, Conrad and Marie and Richard and Mike and Chris and Gillian and Karen and Rob and Jane, Ian and Josephine. It goes on. Tony Helen and Mick and Sid and Paul and Neil and Marilyn, and they're all there. They're all there, lots of people. So we're going to have a wonderful meetup. Do remember, it's 12:45 tomorrow, today, less than just over 12 hours ago away. Getting a little excited here. And we'll all be sitting in the studio. Well, we won't all be sitting in the studio, considering we've only got... three chairs other than the presenter's chair. So a lot of you are going to be stood up, watching the action, taking your part by sitting in the chair from time to time, getting your picture taken, letting the next person come in, having the interview, some more pictures taken, having a bit of fun and chatting with each other and talking 60s music. So 12:45 here at BBC Radio Sheffield. Be here, all right? We're looking forward to meeting you. And we've got Sarah, who has sent in a message here. Let me just get it up for you, Sarah. And she is asking for this one. She said, today has been a bit pence on TV, and she's been living the rock and roll. I'm trying to find her message again here. She's living the rock and roll life of painting the skirting boards today. Bless her. This is not a song to paint to, by the way, Sarah.
And you, Sid, fantastic. Lovely to see you. And your harmonica playing and everything else. You're welcome. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Cheers, Sid.
And Maxine, you made it, darling.
I am. Yeah.
I'm so proud of you. So proud of you, darling.
It's nice of Diana to take time out to meet us all and show us the studio. And it's quite interesting to see a bit about how it's recorded.
Have you all had enough fudge? Because it's funny.
Thank you, my dear.
Lovely to meet. And we need to hear more from you. Maureen, will you? Get him, I know he's not techno-friendly. Oh, not that I haven't hugged Helen. What's going on here?
No,
you're too shy, Helen. I don't believe that's really who you are. I don't think so.
Don't
lovely
think so
to
either.
See you. Have a good time at the pub. It's really nice there, mate.
Someone's got to keep leasing in order now.
Good luck, yeah.
Well, that's it now. We've had a wonderful meet-up again, our second meet-up, this time at BBC Radio Sheffield. Thank you to so many of you for coming out. It's been great meeting you. Hope you enjoyed the fudge. We'll be chatting with you soon, I'm sure.